Welcome viewers, myself Sriram Pandey, assistant professor at Mohalla Sukhari University, Udaipur. Today I am going to talk about Dublin Core Metadata Initiative. So in next couple of minutes, we will discuss different bibliographic description format available in digital library domain. We will also discuss the Dublin Core Metadata Initiative in detail with their element and the future direction of Dublin Core Initiative. So, before understanding the Dublin Core metadata's elements, let us understand bibliographic description format. Bibliographic description format is basically a formal definition of syntax, meaning and rules for describing resources. Resources may be anything. It may be a web resource, it may be a printed resource, it may be a book or any kind of resources. Basically, Dublin bibliographic description format is a set of rules for describing library resources used back in 19th century and still we use the same. So, there are different bibliographic description formats are available. One of the most popular bibliographic description format is Mark 21, which is most popular bibliographic description format used in many of the library automation as well as various other software. Dublin Core got so much popularity, which is the scope of our talk, and BibTeX, apart from that, BibTeX is there, ISBD is there, FRBR is there, and resource description and access is there. So, let us discuss Dublin Core Metadata Initiative. So, the mission of Dublin Core Metadata Initiative, which is in short form it is known as DCMI, is make it easy to find resources using the internet by following activities. One is developing metadata standards, just like DCMI developed Dublin Core Metadata element, defining framework and facilitating the development of community. So, DCMI is basically responsible for Dublin Core metadata element. It is also known as popularly known as Dublin Core elements. Currently, there are 15 core main elements of the Dublin Core. So, let us discuss one by one. So, before going to discuss the Dublin Core element, let us have a look on history of Dublin Core. Dublin Core basically started in 1994 as a simple tag to describe the web pages. Later, it got so much popularity in 1996 and Dublin Core element expanded its scope to the 15 elements. So, these 15 core elements is known as core element of the Dublin Core. In 2000, Dublin Core Metadata Initiative recommends qualifier which broaden its organizational scope beyond the core element. So, basically as I say, Dublin Core consists of 15 elements. So, these are first element of the Dublin Core, if we arrange alphabetical, it is a contributor. Contributor basically carries the person responsible for the contributing content of the resources. Just like if there is a edited book, there are many contributors associated with that. So, contributor element carries name of those persons. Coverage describes geographical coverage of the content, while creator indicates the person responsible for making the content of the resources. Date indicates the creation date of the resource, while description contains an abstract table of content or any other information useful for the resource. Format carries the digital document type, its physical characteristic, while identifier describe the ID of the resource. It may be a URI, ISBN, ISSN or DOI. Language carries the language of the resource, while the publisher describe entity responsible for publishing the resource. Relation carries the reference to the resources. Write element of the Dublin Core contain information related to the write management, and many of the digital library software using this element to preserve integrity and right management related issues. Sources describe the source of the resource while subject contain the keywords, and title carries the title information of the resource. Type describes the nature of the resource. So, in nutshell, in the summary, we can see that every resource on the web, such as file or a web page, can be described using Dublin Core metadata, but there are many limitations of Dublin Core metadata elements. One is limitation is Dublin Core metadata elements is very elastic in nature, which means that it does not specify what a certain element should contain. For example, if the created element is used as a describing the resources, what would be the value of resource? It cannot be described. It may be a actual name, it may be identified, which is not clear at all. So, if we see the Dublin Core in digital library perspective, different type of digital libraries use different bibliographic standards. So, semantic integration becomes very difficult because they are following different type of bibliographical. Some of the digital library following Dublin Core, some of the digital libraries following METS, some of the digital library following encoded archive description. There are variety of bibliographic description format is available. So, semantic integration becomes a very crucial issue in digital library domain. So, digital library need to come one step forward and transform for simple content provided to highly interconnected content powered by semantics. So, in this scenario, bibliographic ontologies, there are a lot of bibliographic ontologies developed based on the bibliographic description format. Suppose that Mark 21 is there, Mark Onto is developed. So, which may be a solution and which may present a framework for the digital library of the future. Thank you.